Hey everybody, this is the Mega Bloks Call of Duty 2016 Desert Tank Set, misnamed, very obviously, because it's not a tank at all, it's a Bradley fighting vehicle, isn't it? Pretty well reproduced one at that. I guess they just didn't get the full official license to use the Bradley name and such, so they went with something more generic. It's not the first time they've done it, and it's not a big deal. Again, it's a good-looking Bradley fighting vehicle. I think that the main cannon barrel is too long, but beyond that, they've covered most of it. I feel like this is one of the more basic or older variants. I do wish that it had the dust shield in front of the either tow or javelin. I'm assuming it's the older basic tow missile system over there, but that launcher, tube launcher, does have a couple of actual missiles in there that are pushed in, so you can actually push one out a little bit if you want to make it look like the thing is firing. This looks pretty good from pretty much every angle, and this is fully built up. There are a lot of pieces in this thing. 848 pieces in the entire set in total, and it's just a really thick and very solid thing. Solid except for the open areas on the inside where you can actually put figures and such. This does have the ability to rotate the very low profile turret around. You can elevate the main barrel with its coaxial machine gun barrel sticking out there. You've got the top hatch on the turret. You've got a hatch in the front as well, which is more of a maintenance access hatch. Look at a little bit of the detail inside of there. I'm assuming that's supposed to represent a big radiator there. There's also a pop-up hatch for a driver or commander to stick his head out. At the rear, meanwhile, there's the dual-mode ingress-egress hatch system with the single, you know, one-at-a-time hatch here, and also the full ramp, full tailgate that comes down for rapidly loading and unloading troops from the inside, and also loading and unloading ammo. So here you've also got munitions on the side with additional missiles that can be used with the tube there. While we're looking at this at a low angle, might as well take a look at it from some other angles as well, because I think the thing looks really nice. It has a very nice profile to it. A lot of details for the sake of details. You know, things are built up with very different shapes just to kind of break things up so nothing looks too smooth, nothing looks too continuous. It's nice. It really has great presence just sitting on a desk or table, just like this. You're also able to take the entire roof off, not just the turret, but all of this comes off to get easier access to the interior. There's nothing really to see on the underside of this, but in there, there's some stuff. You've got a seat for your driver, and he's actually able to use a steering yoke, and there are some printed pieces around the sides representing all sorts of console-type stuff. A little bit tough to see down in there. You get to appreciate it. I'm talking about down there. There's also this one here for the turret operator, but down for your main driver. You get to appreciate those pieces when you're initially putting them in, but afterwards, visibility is just a little bit limited back there, but you still get to see it a bit. It's a little bit cramped to get down in there. This is your engine compartment off to the side. They put a little bit of detail inside of there as well, rather than just closing that off. So that's pretty nice, and that's continuous with the hatch, the maintenance hatch in the front, so you can look right through there. It's all part of the same assembly, and you can stand a person here in the turret. Also put one off to the side here, looking at some battlefield data, the display, see some coordinates and probably, you know, troop, you know, friendly troop movements, friend and foe identifiers would be showing up on there and such, and just a more clear look at the extra missiles. So all of them, including the two that are in the tube, look just like that. These are the three figures included with the set, with a lot of variants between them, different types of weapons. And I think that for me, the highlight of everything that I'm looking at here is the M40 sniper rifle on the right, which is pretty beautiful, and you can actually remove the scope, you can remove the bipod attachment, you can remove the magazine, and you can even remove the suppressor from the end of it, which is just a plain tube piece. I mean, it's too large, but there's a little bit of molding, custom molding on the end of the barrel there as well. these first two are supposed to be just generic soldiers. They don't have any official names, but this is a licensed Captain Price on the right. And let me know what you think about this. I think the facial hair is just way too dark. I should not have gone with that almost black there. If they were going for an older Price, then, you know, make it more salt and pepper like. Still, I feel like it should have been more in the brown range. Otherwise, you know, you recognize what they were trying to go for, but I do think that was a miss with the color. Lots of different colors here, you know, even though they did go with the desert camo general scheme. Also, different molds of feet, from here to here, the lower legs. The arms have different molds, so these two are the same, but that one's different. And the torsos have different molds as well, which you can quickly see from looking at the collar sections on the top. Two different types of vests here, and there are some more accessories included as well. So you get all this stuff, and it is a little bit odd that you have the old World War II style flashlight included with this set. It just doesn't go with the timeline, but it is what it is. You can use it as something else if you want to. Nice riot shield here. These are the modern style of bases for figures. It's just a general silicone rubber strap that you can use to, you know, attach a weapon. Actually have a shoulder strap for one. And then there's this, a nice rifle case, which actually does hinge open. You can open this thing up, and it's got a nice gunmetal gray paint application on the inside of the top. Down here, it actually has foam, and that comes kind of pre-glued, probably has some contact cement on the other side. I didn't try pulling it off, but that's nice. It's kind of plush, and the idea is that this is the case for the M40, so you can kind of start to break the M40 down and, you know, just get that settled in there, and it won't really rattle around because it's going to have to be pushed in to the foam a bit. You know, just put the individual items in there. They don't have inserts in there. I suppose if you want to do a little bit of customization, you could kind of cut into that to make these fit a little bit better. But let me also just get the suppressor. You know, just have a little setup here. It's not perfect, but you can get all that in there. Squish it together. It's not rattling around thanks to the foam, and it's just a nice looking little thing. I appreciate that additional inclusion. Here's what it looks like with the three figures put inside. So one guy sits down in the driving compartment. A key with that one is to attach his hands to the control stick there, the steering wheel, first, and then get him situated. This guy over here in the back, who's just kind of a passenger, is just attached with a peg to the back so he's not going to fall off. And right now I've got Captain Price up here just standing because there is enough room beneath the turret for him to fit in there. Leave the hatch open like that, do something like that. It doesn't actually pop out there. If you want to actually have him sticking out, you kind of have to just widen his arms out and have him kind of supporting himself on his arms. There's one piece that was missing from the set, unfortunately, one of these clip pieces, so I did go ahead and leave that off rather than filling it in with one of my own spare pieces. Just wanted to point that out. Also, there's a little bit of confusion in the instructions right around here. If you get the set, you get to building it, you'll see it. Just a couple of the steps show some confusion, but it's very easy to figure out what they're actually going for by just seeing what it looks like after it's already completed a couple steps later on. But other than that, no issues with part fitment, thankfully. Another really nice looking, realistic, modern war machine build from Mega Bloks. Very satisfied with this one. The only thing that I do worry about with this is the track set, because Mega Bloks does have a bad track record, excuse the pun, for tracks that actually split apart at their connection point, their seam, because their loops are formed by just taking a band and ultrasonically welding the whole thing into a loop or something like that. Hopefully these will last longer. Hopefully they have learned from that continuous issue that they've had for a number of years now, but that just remains to be seen, and I won't be able to find that out for some weeks, if not months. Usually it takes a while before those things snap. So that's the one thing to look out for. Otherwise, very happy with what I see here. I'm very happy with the actual build process itself. Happy with the accessories for the figures, the variation amongst the figures themselves, I do recommend that you go for a shorter barrel length for the main turret, if you want to have just a little bit more realism. But otherwise, I think they've done a pretty nice job here. Let me know what you think. Share your thoughts in the comment section if you would like to. It's always good to see different perspectives from different folks. Talk to you again soon.